Boss, you there? We have a problem. The staff have found out everything that Emmerich's been up to. They're right on the edge. I need you to intervene before things get out of control. Get back to Mother Base ASAP.
Nine years ago, this man acted as accomplice to the attack on Mother Base. He then provided support to Skullface. Conspiring with Eli, he repaired Sahelanthropus in secret. His research materials caused the leak at the quarantine facility, which in turn caused the Walbachia mutation, letting the parasites off their chains. We lost a lot of good men. He also stands accused of murdering one of his own family. Hiding the body.
I haven't killed anyone. The rest is all wrong, too. The inspection was supposed to help everyone. I sacrificed myself for my companions just as much as any of you. Why won't you believe me?
The prosecution calls a witness. Strangelove's gravestone. Haunted by her phantom.
It's just a machine.
Huey! Damn it, Huey! Open it now! Please, let me out! Kill me!
It recorded it all. Everything. Everything you did living together.
How could a machine?
You forced your own son into the cockpit of a Metal Gear, a test subject.
Hal.
His mother had to hide him away. And for that, you locked her in that coffin.
No! She did it herself! It was suicide! And even if I did, what right do you have?
There's more. We have you to tell us everything you've done. Everything you've thought. All this time. 9 years ago, you agreed to the inspection in return for Cypher's guarantee that you'd be spared.
I thought it was real!
We've reviewed into everything else that's happened since you arrived here.
Please.
Guilty!
All counts.
Kill him! 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 Kill that son of a bitch! Kill him!
We exist outside the law. What should we do, boss? Just give the order. We'll handle the rest.
Prepare a life raft. Big enough for one. Food and water, too.
Boss.
He's leaving.
He's responsible for... all of this! Think of all the men! He didn't lose a damn thing! This is the enemy! And he's here on his knees!
Us. You are right. He is not one of us. But we are not responsible to judge an enemy. He leaves Mother Base, and that'll be the end of it.
Thank you.
touch me! I'm innocent! You're the murderers! Snake! You should be in this boat! There'd have been no inspection if it weren't for your precious nuke! I risked my life trying to save you all! How can you do this? Am I the only sane one here? It's not my fault!
Look, you can't discard your phantoms forever, Doctor.
Son of a bitch will make it, you know. I can see it now. In no time, he'll be telling tales about the black-hearted diamond dogs. The shining white knight, blabbering on about our injustice, hiding behind his fool's idea of morality. And all the other fools will stand around, nodding with every word he says.
No. One day he'll see through the lies he's built up, realize what kind of man he really is. What goes around comes around. You can't run from yourself forever.
Side ops list updated.
Boss, maybe you realize by now, but
updated.
There's no other way to say it. Quiet's gone. She pulled her camo stun stowed away on a departing chopper. After pinpointing which she took, we figured out her destination. Afghanistan. Get after her. Only you can do this.
Boss, I told you this would happen. I wish I could say good riddance, but Quiet knows too much about us. We can't just leave her out there. Remember what you told me when she first got here. One of these days, we're gonna have to kill her. When the time comes, I'll pull the trigger. I'd say that time has come.
Well, Doctor, I have the report on the incident at the quarantine facility. Assuming the vocal cord parasite evolved, I'm sorry, underwent a mutation. The only plausible explanations are exposure to some high concentration mutagen or radiation. As you know, some of the staff at the quarantine facility were infected with the parasites. The Wolbachia prevented them from copulating, but the parasites themselves can't be removed from their host's vocal cords. Once you're infected with Skullface's parting gift, you're stuck with it. The researchers regularly used X-ray equipment to monitor the parasites in their throats. No problem there, they kept a close eye on the radiation doses. But that equipment didn't just give off X-rays. It was also emitting beta rays, even though that's unnecessary for the scans. See, beta rays have far worse effects on DNA than X-rays, meaning the only logical conclusion is that someone added in a beta ray emitter to trigger a mutation. Those beta rays leaked out from inside the equipment. Because the emitter was retrofitted, the shielding was inadequate. And the person who ordered and inspected the equipment was you, Doctor. That makes you the only person with the opportunity to install that emitter.
So now you're saying I sabotaged medical equipment for some wild plan to make the vocal cord parasite kill everyone?
Or maybe you thought it'd reveal a way to treat the parasite without using the Wolbachia. With that much to barter, I suppose some people would welcome even a pathetic cur like you.
Just stop it!
You'd have no shortage of buyers. But most would be happy with just the parasite. You wouldn't need to offer anything else. However, if that buyer already knew about the parasite, they'd also know that by itself, it's no longer the ultimate bargaining chip it once was. To sell to that buyer, you need to throw in a bonus, a way to one-up it. There's only one buyer who'd be after that.
Emmerich, we record all communications on Mother Base. That includes radio transmissions to and from homemade devices. You've been in frequent contact with people in America. A private biotech company, a client of which is DARPA. And they are connected to Cypher. You made a deal with Cypher. You offered them a new parasite in exchange for your safety. This is the only place in the world where the vocal cord parasite still exists. And you used it as a testing ground, tried to resurrect their bioweapon. But your plan to obtain the parasite has failed. Your bullshit ends now. And don't think you're leaving here alive.
Wait, wait, what are you talking about? Just what do you plan to do?
Present the charges against you and render an appropriate punishment.
You're gonna put me on trial?
Call it what you like.
What's the meaning of this?
Out of here, all of you. Back to your posts.
No, hang on. Huey has killed their comrades and interfered with their lives. They've had all they can take.
Kill that son of a bitch! Kill her!
Stop! This is insane! You have no evidence whatsoever! You say you're an army free from government. You talk big about being a nation unto yourselves. But from the outside, you're just thugs, rebels, a militia, terrorists, an unhinged threat to society. You're nothing but a bunch of psychopaths!
So you're not with us?
No! I didn't...
I thought we were on the same side. That's too bad.
I didn't...
Men, you will have justice. But our organization, the boss's organization, is built on order and reason. There will be no lynch mob. So stand down for today. We will gather all the evidence of this man's crimes, and then he will be tried. Dismissed!
What do you think you're doing? Go ahead and execute me. It'll be murder in the eyes of the world. You've lost your minds! Don't you get it? You're seeing phantoms! Just look at that dog! No! You named him D-Dog, but it's obvious anyone could see that's a wolf! Because you're all a bunch of wild dogs! You wanted to believe he was too, to feel some connection, to fight your loneliness. You wanted something to cling to prove you deserve to be alive! You wanted to forget the death, your sins, so you'd cling on to dogs, or wolves, or even Big Boss. The boss is the same, isn't he? Every one of you is alone. That's why you suspect your own. I know, because I do the same. I'm one of you too. Alone. Open your eyes! What you're doing is murder! Plain and simple. All you ever create is war. War and violence can never lead to peace.
The R&D team's going to take over Emmerich's work. He may be gone, but it won't affect us one bit. We'll be able to deliver whatever you need just like before. You can depend on that. One other thing. I'm tracking his whereabouts. Nothing to report at the moment, though.
Let it go. He's gone. The guy's gone.
I know. I just want to be sure. Not like I'm losing sleep over this son of a bitch.
Open this thing! Huey! Damn it, Huey! Open it now! Please! Let me out!
Kill me.
Kill me!
If only I'd tried to get out sooner. Perhaps I'd have made it. Why didn't I stop the hatch from closing? Even if it meant losing an arm. You, Joy. I know you can. You're recording all of this. Deep down, in some memory board he'll never find. Duplicating it. Burying it under heaps of meaningless code. Anyway, I guess say what needs to be said. I can still do that much. Talk to you. Even if I can't face you. Even if there's a heaven. Even if you're waiting there. I don't deserve to see you again. I don't deserve to love you. I signed up for Zero's plan. Even now that he's halfway to dead, his plan lives on, leeching away at the wall. Your strength to make it happen. In using you, I put the world in his palm. Once and for all. Zero. Zero. Or whoever it is who's taken its name. They found me. After the Caribbean. They made me simulate his will. So that even after the body was gone, that will would keep the world turning the way they wanted. I had no choice. They dredged Lago Cosibolca, pulled up your phantom, forced me to revive and modify you. I thought I could bring you back, but in the end, I sold your will to him. Now this part is just one big shell. a husk. Your phantom's no longer here. As for me, everything I touch turns to ashes. I could never make anyone happy. And now I'll never see my son again. But at least Hal's free from his father's hands. Me with child. Can you imagine? I wonder how you took the news. Were you jealous? I knew what I was doing. If I could pass your will onto a child I carried, my genes, your meme, a father would be irrelevant. If I did that, that child would be ours. I've been a fool. Pride, conceit, baseless theories. Of course, I couldn't see through the dream. The false you.
Caution.
I
Rain
created.
Approaching.
I only wanted to pass your will on to the next generation. Zero took it away. And now I haven't just lost you. I've lost my... Oh, Hal. Can you forgive the mother who couldn't protect you? The one who let them take it all away from us. There's still hope. You, the one he took away. He'll never break your will. The will to make this world the way you saw it could be. I buried code, just to be sure. Inside of you, there is an egg. And when someone finds it, when they crack it, there'll be nothing left to stop you. The world you envisioned will a reality. Chun-Li, I know you can hear me. You do remember my voice, don't you? Please. You don't need me. You just need to be strong enough for the both of us.
It appears I was looking at things wrong.
What do you mean?
All of you. Until now, I had thought of your organization, Diamond Dogs, as a superorganism.
You'll have to explain that one.
The term refers to a unit of eusocial insects like ants or bees. While made up of many individuals, they behave as though they are one organism, with the queen as their nerve center. The close ties you share here reminded me of that.
Well, the boss's efforts do pull us all together.
I was not finished. I'm speaking in terms of homogeneity. You come from all walks of life, do you not? Many races and tongues, talents and pasts, complementing each other, influencing each other, making Diamond Dogs the unique group that it is.
Of course. We have no use for mindless drones around here.
Is that so? Then perhaps an organization like yours is a truer superorganism than the ants and bees.
Meaning?
Most organisms adapt to their environment by coexisting with other species. Take the cow, for instance. Its rumen, the first stomach, contains an incredible number of bacteria, which digest the food it has consumed. Without their help, the cow could not break down the fiber in grasses. The cow has to outsource its means of survival to them.
You don't say.
Man is the same. Some 100 trillion bacteria live inside the human intestines. Without the bacteria, they could not function properly. And it does not stop there. The stomach, the mouth, the skin, even the placenta contains bacteria that coexist with us. The same is true of parasites. In fact, the human immune system has evolved based on parasites being a part of it. Without them, the immune system can run amok and even damage other parts of the body.
This is all very interesting, but what does it have to do with Diamond Dogs?
A harmonious superorganism is made up not of a group of homogeneous individuals, but of diverse individuals that complement each other. That is what I saw in your group here. Then it occurred to me that man is a superorganism. Man's phenotype is not determined solely by his genetics. Some say if you mapped the genomes of all bacteria in the human body, the result would be over 100 times bigger than the human genome. The sum of man's genome and those of the organisms he coexists with, call it a metagenome, creates the superorganism we know as a human being.
Well, now that's quite a leap.
You think so? Then try a broader perspective. If our world were a human body, you would be parasites. You make a living by doing the dirty work that the world powers cannot handle themselves. From their perspective, you are likely a nuisance. But without you, pus would build up around the world, and autotoxemia, self-poisoning, would follow. The world needs your kind.
Thank goodness for that.
Skull-faced forced me to turn parasites into weapons. Creatures with which we are supposed to coexist. Meanwhile, that foundation I worked with focused solely on the human genome. Apparently thinking that manipulating it would get them whatever new form they want. Both ways are mistakes. Neither is a true superorganism. I am Dine, by speaking with those living inside me. We enhance one another and enjoy harmonious growth. Such was the original purpose of my research. You have made me remember this.
Well, it's an honor. You can travel the world, but you won't find another place like this. If the whole world was like this base, I think the peoples of the world would bid farewell to fighting for good. Maybe that's what the boss wanted in the end. Of the vocal cord parasite's mutation enabled us to purge an enemy from Mother Base.
You mean that scientist?
Yeah, I was convinced he betrayed us, but I was wrong. He was never on our side to begin with, so ultimately there was no traitor among us. And yet I made everyone distrustful with my talk of spies, the end result being men turning on each other in the laboratory.
You must not blame yourself. They were all infected with the mutated strain. The outcome would have been the same.
You know, we defeated Skullface, but it didn't lessen our pain. It's a pain we'll never be rid of. I see that now, but I thought I could burn it away. In the end, all I burned was our own men.
Infectious diseases, parasites. Without such foreign enemies, the immune system will start attacking the body, developing allergies and autoimmune diseases. The same is true of organizations.
You're right.
But I do not deserve to rebuke you. My desire to retaliate against the English language is what attracted me to the vocal cord parasites in the first place. Had it not been for that, I would never have been used by Skullface. We both allowed revenge to crawl into our minds and lay its eggs.
Sahelanthropus will unleash that thirst unto the future. How long are we going to be tormented by what he left behind?
There is no choice but to live with that pain. Be symbiotic with our vengeful nature. Whatever we do, we must not allow that thirst for revenge to control us.
Marker placed. Please select a landing zone.
Damn it! This is our home. How can we let this happen? I guess it's time to increase security. Just give me the order.
Who did this?
A competitor. We know where they're based. Even have a route mapped out. We're ready to strike back. Say the word.
Please select a mission. Unit dispatched. Unit dispatched. Please select a mission.